Today we celebrate the feast of the most holy body and the blood of Jesus. We have the opportunity to know and to share the eternal life thanks to our belief in Jesus. Today we also will be witnesses to special sacraments that are happening during this Mass. The rite of Christian initiation, called RCIA, is a journey for those that were seeking initiation into the Catholic faith. Usually, these sacraments are received after the conclusion of their journey, which happens on Easter Vigil. Due to the current pandemic situation, this had to be postponed until today. During this Mass, following the homily, there will be all those who have been on this journey will be baptized and confirmed and followed by the Holy Eucharist. As the baptized faithful, all of us watching and all of us present, it's our job to pray for those who have said yes to Jesus today, and we thank you in advance for that. At this time, we please invite you to silence and turn off your cell phones and pagers, and please refrain from chewing gum. And you have a program at your seat if you want to follow along with the music. Our opening hymn is All Are Welcome, and our celebrant this morning is Father Dave, our pastor. Please stay.
Holy God, holy and mighty, A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses said to the people, "Remember how for 40 years now the Lord your God has directed all your journeying in the desert, so as to test you by affliction and find out whether or not it was your intention to keep his commandments. He therefore let you be afflicted with hunger, and then fed you with manna, a food unknown to you and your fathers, in order to show you that not by bread alone does one live, but by every word that comes forth from the mouth of the Lord." forget the Lord your God, who brought you out of the land of Egypt, that place of slavery, who guided you through the vast and terrible desert, with its seraph serpents and scorpions, its parched and waterless ground, who brought forth water for you from the flinty rock, and fed you in the desert with manna, a food unknown to your fathers. The word of the Lord. Lo, the angel's food is given to the pilgrim who has striven. See the children's bread from heaven, which on dogs may not be spent. Truth the ancient types fulfilling, Isaac bound, a victim willing, Paschal lamb, its lifeblood spilling, manna to the Father sent. Very bread, good shepherd, tend us. Jesu, of your love befriend us. You refresh us, you defend us. Your eternal goodness send us in the land of life to see. You who all things can and know, who on earth such food bestow, grant us with your saints, though lowest, where the heavenly feast you show, fellow heirs and guests to be. Amen. Alleluia.
There's a lot of barriers to understand the gospel. There's a lot of barriers to understand what Corpus Christi, the feast of today, celebrates. The first barrier might be something you've heard, might be something you we've seen in action. The first barrier is the fact that a host about this big and the wine in the chalice doesn't look like Jesus. Doesn't look like a person. And so we're reminded that seeing might be believing, but all the things that we see or don't see, these things might not be as they appear. So for example, this air that we breathe is filled with radio waves, microwaves, and other kinds of waves. We don't see that, but it's there nonetheless. Look at the person next to you. This morning, a lot of the persons are pretty solemn looking today. Does that mean that they're upset? Does that mean that they're frustrated? Does that mean that they're just in a solemn frame of mind without any joy in their heart? How can you tell? You're sitting right next to them, you're looking at them. How can you tell what's going on inside? This is a common thing, of course. Things aren't always what they look like. But the barriers don't stop there. The barriers to Jesus being the fulfillment, being manna itself, the barriers to Jesus being the Messiah are alive and well today, just as they were alive and well in Jesus' time. There were plenty of people who looked Jesus eye to eye, who saw Jesus, but then realized that in their point of view, he was not the Savior, he was not the Messiah, and you all have heard the reasons why. We know where he's from, but nobody knows where the Messiah is from. He eats and drinks with sinners. He doesn't follow the Torah the way our group does, the law of Moses. How can somebody from Galilee be the Messiah? That's far from Jerusalem, far from the center, far from the temple, far from all that is good in the world. And the list goes on and on. Jesus and his disciples didn't fast, while the disciples of John the Baptist and the disciples of the Pharisees fasted. What kind of a Savior dies on the cross? But once you overcome those barriers, there still is yet another barrier. In this gospel, we heard 5 or 6 times an insistence upon Jesus' lips. I am the life. You need to eat my flesh and drink my blood if you are going to have life in its fullness. He repeats that. It's prefaced by those amen, amen words, which usually indicate importance here. And yet, for some people, the objection made early in the gospel still rings true. How can this man give us his flesh to eat? How can we eat the flesh of somebody else? How can we eat the flesh of our Savior? Isn't that cannibalism? Are we called to be cannibals? Later on in this gospel, later on in this chapter, even the disciples of Jesus would leave him because they didn't understand. But we need to think a little bit. We need to think to overcome this particular obstacle. We need to think if there's anything where somebody is consuming part of the body of somebody else, and it is not considered cannibalism. And over 1,600 years ago, St. John Chrysostom found such a thing. We've all been involved in it. We've all done it. Anybody who's born, babies in the womb, they consume the blood of the mother. They eat part of the mother. We don't consider that cannibalism. Maybe that's because there's a tight bond of love between mother and there not a kind of bond of love between the Savior and us? It can be the case. It is the case that what is going on in this gospel is far away from cannibalism, and yet that barrier comes before us, and yet we find ourselves from time to time stuck like that. But it doesn't have to be. Corpus Christi is a day in which we are reminded that, yes, there's a lot of obstacles we need to overcome. But when we do overcome those obstacles, we're able to see the Word, we're able to understand the sacrament, we're able to understand life itself in a whole different perspective. And today, we've come together. And today, in part of our celebration, a great part, is that we welcome others who are willing to overcome these same obstacles, to see the world in a different way. We welcome those who have journeyed in the Rite of Christian Initiation program for adults. We welcome them, not just by smiles, but by the power of grace itself in baptism, in confirmation, and in the Eucharist. We are people who overcome barriers to see the words Christ insists upon. We celebrate that in humility as we welcome our brothers and sisters through the waters of baptism, through the entrance to the church, to the table of the Lord. So now I would invite those who are to be baptized, and altar servers, and the godparents of those who are to be baptized, to follow me to the baptism font.
Pray for us.
Saint Teresa.
Pray for us. Saint George,
pray for us.
All holy men and women,
pray for us.
Lord, be merciful.
Lord, be
merciful. From all evil, Lord,
save your people.
From every sin,
Lord, save your people.
From everlasting death,
Lord, save your people.
By your coming as man, Lord,
save your people.
By your death and rising to new life,
Lord, save your people.
By your gift of the Holy Spirit,
Lord, save your people.
Be merciful to us sinners. Lord, hear our prayer. Give new life to these chosen ones by the grace of baptism.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Jesus, Son of the living God,
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord Jesus, hear our prayer.
Lord Jesus, hear our prayer.
I do.
Do you reject Satan, father of sin, prince of darkness?
I do.
Do you reject Satan and all his works and all his empty promises?
I do.
Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, was crucified, died, rose from the dead, and is now seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body?
I do.
This is our faith. We are proud to profess it in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
My brothers and sisters, I ask you now, is it your will that you be baptized into the faith which we have all professed? Very good. And your godparents, please come forward.
Frank Citrovsky.
This candle, the Easter candle, which symbolizes the light of Christ that has yet again come into the world, we light these small candles. See them are a reminder of their new life in Christ who is light of the world, and with your godparents, and with the community. Grow in that light. We ask these things through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We now ask those who are to be confirmed to please come forward, along with their spouses. Dearly beloved, the gift of the Holy Spirit which you are about to receive will be a spiritual seal by which you will be conformed to Christ and will be made more fully members of His Church. For Christ Himself anointed by this Holy Spirit in baptism that He received from John was sent forth for the work of His ministry to pour out on the earth the fire of the same Spirit. The living members of this church, therefore, and under the guidance of the Holy Spirit, seek to serve all people like Christ, who came not to be served, but to serve. And now, before we receive the Holy Spirit, let us bow our heads in prayer, asking for the grace needed to open the hearts to a gift of this magnitude. Dearly beloved, let us pray to God, the Almighty Father, for these, his adopted children, his sons and daughters, already born to eternal life and baptism, that he will graciously pour out the Holy Spirit upon them to conform them with his abundant gifts, and through this anointing, conform them more fully to Christ, the Son of God. Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who brought these your servants to new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, free them from sin. Send upon them, O Lord, the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete. Give them the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and fortitude, the spirit of knowledge and piety. Fill them with the spirit of the fear of the Lord through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Confirmed and on faith, these are brothers and sisters who are close to us and are preparing now for the sacrament of the Eucharist on this feast of Corpus Christi. Enjoy us again, express our pleasure that they are with us. Let us join one another in prayer, praying not only for those who have received the confirmation and baptism, but also praying for all those who are in need. We lift up our voices. We pray the prayer of faith.
This Mass is offered for the repose of the souls of Mark Vandervoort, Jose Y. Feliciano, and Donald Tapp. For these intentions, let us continue to pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Pope Francis, our bishop, priests, and all who serve the Church, may the Lord strengthen them in their mission of bringing the light of Christ to a weary world. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our civic leaders and all who help formulate public policy, may the Holy Spirit guide them in all that they do. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the young people in our communities, most especially those achieving milestones like graduations, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all unborn children, that our love for them may keep them safe until the joyous day of their birth, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our men and women in uniform, may they be protected in their time of need and their families sustained in these uncertain times. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this gathered assembly, may the love and truth that God has poured into our hearts sustain us in all that we do. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our faithful departed, including Bill Hahn, for whom Our Lady of Grace candle burns this week, may they now rejoice in God's heavenly kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our personal petitions, let us pause in silence. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray in thanksgiving for those who have been baptized and affirmed this day, this year, for those who have gone through the RCA program. We pray also for our RCA team. We pray that the seed sown may grow to bear abundant fruit. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
good and gracious God, you never cease to call us. Give us joy in your call. Give us strength to follow it, and give us the light that comes from knowing. We ask these things through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Servant Song.
Oh,
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Father Almighty. Church, O Lord, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace, whose signs are to be seen in mystery, in the offerings we here present, through Christ our Lord. So that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and the blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." So that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, Saint George, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm with faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Oscar, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. Your compassionate and merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Your departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
to sin. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give to you," not in our sins, but on the faith of your church, graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, to live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
We ask that those who are to receive First Communion come forward first, and then as normal we begin from the back and bring people forward. Thank you.
Savior, Savior.
Second collection today is for Cruzy Hall. The main thing we have to do to complete the hall is to get the wrought iron helping to put the railings back. They will be inspected. So the end is near. This kind of room is.
Let us pray.
Grant, O Lord, we pray that we may delight for all eternity in the share in your divine law, which is foreshadowed in the present age, by reception of your precious body and
something rather than look at. So just give us a call and we'll put you in the list.
Thank you.
Now we invite those who were baptized, confirmed, or had their first communion to come forward. Just those who were baptized and confirmed. You're not with your godparents this time, you're all by yourselves. May the Lord continue to open your hearts and give you great joy this day. May the memory of the sacraments that you have received be realities in your life. May the graces which God has bestowed abundantly upon you on this day open your hearts and your souls to graces that God bestows every day. We ask that you continue to take delight in the gifts that you have given, that you continue to grow in them, and that you never cease praising the Lord in your hearts. We ask all these things through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
As we go forth knowing that He is the bread of life. Join us.